All right, here we got the fire going. We're gonna be searing this meat now. Bear with me.
Old time,
I get this set up
for your sake alone. I've left my old father, my country, my home. I've left my old mother to weep and to mourn. I am a rebel soldier and far from my home. The great shot in Moscow. Lumber land. This mangled body, the blanket for the shrine. This mangled body left on the fields alone. I am a rebel soul. And far from my home.
All right. You see here, bacon grease is going good. Get it spread out. Got pepper left in it when I fried my bacon. I got this now set on low. I got my kale and plantain in there.
Cup of brandy and a glass of wine.
My deer roast. I've cut it in half to fit it a little easier inside the crock pot. I'm gonna sprinkle a little bit of powder on here, some of that black pepper on both sides. Whoops. Didn't quite get her. There she is. Kind of low light over here. Alright. That's peppered up. And we're gonna sear it in the pan. Nice red, wild game meat. Ain't nothing better. Like I said, we're just gonna sear it. We ain't cooking it. Getting the edges seared real good. Oh yeah. Sometimes I like leaving it in a little bit longer to get a crunchiness going to it. After that cooks off inside the crock pot, that crunchiness to it gets real good. And that smells so freaking good, I almost don't want to take it. I just want to slice it up and eat it. That bacon grease mixed with that deer meat and that pepper is just really, really good. That's going in there. I can already start to smell it. The onion and that kale and the plantain from my yard is just, we've had a, well, it's been drizzling past couple days now. And this stuff has all been washed by God and really fresh, very green. And it just smells, the smell of it is just really good. It's making me want to eat it now, but it's going to be a little bit longer yet. Got a little bit of burn going here. That's that crispiness on the meat. You're gonna taste later on. Makes it really, really good. Kind of move it around in the grease here. It doesn't really need it, but to me, moving around in the grease, I think it just kind of adds a little more and more to it. When you get ready, you shut that heat off. That bacon goes straight in the water. Kind of get it down in there. Put that dude over on high so you can see some of the grease separating from the water in there. That piece of plantain, I plucked that right out of my front yard. It grows all over the place. The kale's high in protein, plantain's good in protein, deer meat's high in protein. Batten down the hatches here. That dude steams up. And it is now almost 10 o'clock. So 8 hours from now, or probably more like 4 hours from now, I'm gonna check it. I'm gonna stick a couple of forks in there and attempt to separate it and see how much resistance it's got. If it doesn't just fall apart, I'm gonna let it keep going. But that's my, that's pretty much how I do my deer roast.